Have you ever wondered, should I start freelance writing or should I start blogging? Now, in 2019, this question is more relevant than ever because blogging is super popular, but it's a very competitive space. With freelance writing, there's tons of people that need content, and it's a great way to make money fast. So in this video, I want to make it super easy to decide if you should start freelance writing or if you should start blogging. Plus, I'm going to make sure to cover the benefits of both, how you can get started quickly, and what I think is the best for the long term. Let's go. Hey everybody, if you're new to the channel, welcome. I want to first off thank you for being here. Again, my name is Michael Leonard and I am a copywriter and creator of Inspire Your Success. So I have been an online entrepreneur for a few years now and have been blogging for about 3 years. So I wanted to kind of break down the biggest differences between freelance writing versus blogging because a lot of people kind of intermix them and it's easy to do. So again, this video is to make sure you understand why you should start freelance writing versus why you should start blogging, and again, making sure it aligns with your goals. All right, so first off is freelance writing. Freelance writing has been a savior in my life. It has literally allowed me to never go back to a 9-to-5. So I'm eternally grateful for freelance writing. But the reason that I went really hard on freelance writing and really started to have a lot of success and get some high-paying clients and get featured in major publications and actually 10x my income in 12 months was because my blog was failing. So that is kind of where I want to start with it, because freelance writing versus blogging is very, very different. So with freelance writing, you are simply working for someone else. You are working for websites or brands or bloggers or other people that need content, and you are simply writing for them, getting paid, and then moving on to the next assignment or the next project. So that right there is the biggest difference, because freelance writing is awesome. I mean, again, you can make money fast, you can get clients relatively quickly, you can scale your income, but you are not working on your stuff. You're still gonna have to hear people tell you, you know, when to give deadlines, or if you didn't write it very well, or respond to emails. You have a lot more responsibility, I guess, in the terms of accountability. So with blogging though, you don't have to worry about that. So I'll get to that in just a second. But with freelance writing, again, there's a lot of pros to it. So I wanna break those down real quick. All right, so the first thing about freelance writing that I briefly mentioned is that you can make money fast. I mean, if you have any sort of experience, whether it's in personal finance or personal development or in a certain sport, I mean, there is literally a need to write content in basically every niche out there. So that is the coolest thing I will say about freelance writing, is that you can start making money fast, because literally all you need is a writing website or a portfolio, and really it comes out to just pitching clients, whether they're in person, cold emailing, cold calling, job boards, Upwork. There's tons of different ways to land freelance writing clients, but the cool thing again is that you make money fast. The second reason freelance writing is great is because you don't have to have a ton of tech skills. Really, becoming a successful freelance writer, whether it's making a couple thousand a month or 5,000 or 10,000 or more, isn't dependent on if you can run a WordPress website or if you can go on and get your widgets, making your website look the right way, or making sure your site speed runs quickly, or Pinterest marketing, or all these other things that bloggers need to worry about. But with freelance writing, it is great because you basically do the blogging side of blogging without everything else that entails entrepreneurship as a blogger. So that is one of the biggest things, that if you're not very techie or you don't want to learn about it, then freelance writing is going to be for you, because really all you do normally is submit your articles, whether it's on a Google Doc or Microsoft Word or some other system that, where you might actually upload directly to WordPress depending on your client. But that's really it. You just have to obviously write quality content, meet their guidelines, meet their deadlines. But then basically you submit it, and then at that point, you know, you either get paid on a bi-weekly or weekly or monthly system, depending on the client. And that's really all you have to do. You don't have to worry about promoting it on Twitter and making a pin for it on Pinterest and running Facebook ads to it. your job is to do the writing side of it. So that is a big, big win. And again, I'll talk more about that as a blogger as well. So while we talked about some of the pros of freelance writing, it's always important to think about the other side of it, because blogging does win on a few other reasons, and I want to talk about some of the cons of freelance writing as well. So the first one, of course, is that you are not building your business. Yes, you're building part of your writing business, but there's no way that you can really scale it in a passive sense, because think about it this way. With blogging, when you create a blog post and it's really good and Google indexes it, it ranks high in search, you know, say that thing is, you know, on the first page or even the top three, if you're really good at writing epic content and getting, you know, high SEO scores, that one piece of content can make you tons of money for years. I mean, you can literally get email opt-ins, affiliate sales, course sales, because you're always having that one piece of content on a search term where people are always going. But with freelance writing, if you created that piece for a client, you're only getting paid that one time. So say you made $200 for that article. Well, that's great. You got that quick income, but that blogger might make $2,000 or $5,000 or $10,000 or more from that post over the long term. So again, that is kind of one of the bummers, is that you can put up a lot of hard work, do a lot of research, you know, interlink everything, make sure the title's great, the images, everything like that. And again, you get that short-term payment, but bloggers and people who are running those websites or blogs are gonna get a lot more money from it. All right, so we covered the two reasons why freelance writing is great, and then kind of one of the downsides, but let's talk more about blogging, because blogging is a great platform. Again, if you basically sign up with WordPress, and then you have some sort of hosting, I use Bluehost and SiteGround. You can take a look at the links down below for kind of blogging resources. But the thing with blogging is that there is a ton of long-term potential, but not nearly as much in the short term. So I want to be very clear. Blogging is a great way to make money online, but it is far from overnight. I mean, it can take you a year before you really start to see consistent income or more. I mean, you see these stats out here of like millions and millions of blogs are created, but only a small percentage of them are actually active. And the reason that is because most people give up before they actually reap the rewards of a blog. So that's the biggest thing I want to say right now, is that blogging is great. There's tons of ways you can monetize it. You can build a tribe, create an email list, products, so many things that I'm gonna talk about here in a second. But that's the biggest thing, is that it's not overnight. So if you need money tomorrow and you need to pay your bills, you need to get that student loan down, I would recommend doing a combination of freelance writing and blogging, or in the short term, strictly going with freelance writing. Because with my clients, I actually have a lot of them where I get paid the day I submit my articles or even that week. So that is nice because, again, it's quick income. You can use it if you're in a financial crunch. If you need more clients and or more money, you can just land more clients. But again, blogging is a lot different. It can take 6 months, a year, or more. And if you look at a lot of income reports from bloggers, you see that they had very little and then it just takes off. So that is really, really important, because most people, if you go on and you see an income report like how I made $100,000 last month, you know, you might be like I was. And at the beginning, when I was working in the 9-to-5 and I was miserable and I was looking for that way out, is that I would see income reports like that and I would think to myself, man, I want to make $100,000 a month. Who doesn't, right? But that's the thing, is that I did not understand what it took to really make money as a blogger. I didn't understand keywords and affiliates and making sure your site ran fast and making sure you have a clear, concise vision for your site and monetizing an email list and all these things that I know now, because at the beginning, I was looking for that short-term fix. So looking back at it, I wish I would have started freelance writing first. That way I became a better writer and I learned more about blogging. But instead, I started blogging, and then it took me a long time to really see anything, and I started to need money. So of course, I started freelance writing, and then I was weighing the two. So again, I'm gonna talk about that more in a second, but if you're really between the two and you need money fast, that is one thing where freelance writing is definitely gonna pay off. But there are a lot of pros to blogging. So yes, it can take a little while, but the biggest thing with blogging is that you can scale the hell out of it, because If you understand how to drive traffic, whether it's through Google SEO, Pinterest pins, or Facebook ads, kind of the big three, if you can crack one or two of those, you can get a lot of traffic to your blog. And then from there, it really comes down to how good and can you monetize it. And that's the cool thing, is that once you really understand kind of what your traffic's doing on the site and you figure out what they want, once you figure out the problems your readers have and you can solve it by an affiliate that you recommend, an online course you create, a coaching program that you make, that is how you can really scale and monetize it. So, for example, if you look at bloggers like Ben and Jeff over at Dollar Sprout and Breaking the 1%, these guys are making over $100,000 a month because they have learned to effectively drive traffic at a low cost to the pages. They rank really high in search results, and then every page is monetized, so it's a great user experience. It has the right products that they recommend, and they make a majority of their income through affiliates. So that is really cool, because again, if you learn how to figure out, you know, getting people to it and then monetizing it, and again, making sure you're providing quality affiliate links and products you believe in, you can scale it. And that is not something you can do with freelance writing, because freelance writing, you are trading your time for money. With blogging, you can create that one post, you know, figure out how to get traffic to it, and that thing can make you money for a long time. Another thing with blogging that is great is that you generate emails, because you offer lead magnets and different freebies and things like that to get people on your email list. And as they always say in marketing, the money is in the list. And that's still true, because if you're selling courses, selling coaching, selling all kinds of things online, if you have a list of people that want and need your services, that is how you sell it. Because when you're freelance writing, though, you're just making money for writing, you submit your work, and then you're on. But again, those bloggers that you write for, those websites that you write for, they are getting emails, and those emails can make them money for years to come. Because again, they're building a tribe of like-minded people. They're cultivating that by sending quality emails. They're sending them videos, articles, whatever they're doing for their blog. They're sending that on a weekly basis or monthly basis, and they're building that know, like, and trust factor. And as they build that up, that email list can then be monetized in tons of different ways. Now that's a perfect segue, because blogging, again, you can make money in a lot of different ways. With freelance writing, you are literally writing, you're typing away, you submit your work, and you get paid one time, and then you're good. But with blogging, you can, again, monetize that so many different ways. So let's break down a couple of the popular ones. Take a look at three of the most popular ways to monetize a blog post. The first one is affiliate marketing. And affiliate marketing, if you don't know, is basically where you recommend a product. If someone signs up for it or buys a subscription or whatever the business model is, you get a percentage of it. So for example, let's say you recommend ClickFunnels as the best teaching platform, and you recommend it to your readers on a blog post. It gets a lot of traffic, whether it's from SEO or Pinterest or Facebook ads or whatever. Say one of your readers goes and they clicks on it and they sign up, $97 a month. Well, ClickFunnels has an affiliate program where you actually get paid every month that they are still in the program. So this is extremely valuable as a blogger, because you can create one piece of content, if it ranks really high and you have a good affiliate program, where you can make money every single month from people that are signing up and staying with that affiliate program. Now, ClickFunnels is kind of a rare example. Not too many of them have these recurring affiliate programs, but a lot of them, for example, like Bluehost, that's who I recommend, you know, you get started with for blogging and freelance writing websites. It's like, you know, $200 for the year to have your hosting. If you sign up through my link, then I would get a portion of it. So I think I get like $60. So that's just a one-time fee. But again, I'm recommending products I believe in, and it's a great way to help your email list or the people that are reading your blog by saying, hey, here's the products I recommend. You know, I've tried XYZ, they're not nearly as good. Here's the best one. You know, I do get money for it. So again, you have to make sure your audience knows you're getting paid. You can't just say, hey, you know, click this, but not mention that you're getting paid for it. But again, that's one of the things, is that you can make money consistently from it. And again, all you're really doing is referring people to buy a product without you having to create anything specific. Right? And then the second thing with blogging is that you can make money by having your own courses. So for example, My blog is all about helping people make money online, build online businesses, and one of the ways that I teach my students and readers is through freelance writing. So I have tons of blog posts, I have videos on this channel, but then I also have a paid course where there's about 50 different lessons. You can go through it, and it's literally A to Z step-by-step guide of how to make a ton of money as a writer. So that is kind of one of the ways that you can make money from it. And again, you're helping your audience out, because instead of reading every blog post on my site and then watching every video and then going to other people's stuff, you package it up into one proven product that has helped you, or something that you've, you know, already familiar with, and speed up the success of others. So that's a great way to make money from it. But if you are a freelance writer, you don't have opportunities like that. So again, that's really two of the biggest ways. And then the third way is coaching. So that's kind of like online courses on steroids. So for example, I do a coaching program on top of my freelance writing program, where it does cost more money, but then they also get 6 weeks of calls with me and emails and text messages and things like that. So as you can tell, there's three main ways there. Again, these are just three. There's tons of ways, including brand sponsorships and ads and things like that. But these are three great ones that you just don't have the opportunity for with freelance writing. But I do not want to just make blogging look like it's easy, because again, it is not. It is one of those things, though, if you can crack the code, you have relevant content, you really can attract an audience, you can make money for a long time with it. So the biggest thing, though, is that most people don't want to learn, and that's the problem, is that you can't just write random stuff on your blog, put it out to your list, and hope it just kind of resonates. It really comes down to creating a strategy. It comes down to doing a keyword strategy proposal, understanding your competitors, what you can rank for, what you can't rank for. So that's one of the biggest things that most people don't want to invest in, but SEO and really understanding what people are searching for on Google is huge. So that's one of the biggest downsides to blogging, is the amount of time it takes to really understand what you're trying to do, and then also how to monetize. One of the things that bloggers seem to not really want to learn about, and I'm included in this, so I don't want you to feel like I'm better or anything like that, because the first few years of blogging, I didn't know anything about this, and it screwed me. So the biggest thing is, if you want to be a successful blogger, for the most part, you need to understand SEO, which is search engine optimization. Basically, you need to figure out how to get your content to rank high on Google so they will know, like, and trust your website, and then show it to their readers. Because again, Google has one job. They want to make sure to provide the best content for what people are searching for. And you want to figure out how to make that content your content. But it's not easy. It's not just about writing the longest post or stuffing keywords or anything like that. There's a ton of different things you need to do. And I learned a lot about it in Mike Pearson's Stupid Simple SEO course, and reading tons of blogs and following Neil Patel and all these other people. And I actually have several articles that are ranking number one on Google. So it's really cool, but again, it takes a while to get there. So if you want to be a successful blogger, make sure you're actually investing in your SEO knowledge, because again, it can pay you out for a long time. And once you get one, you kind of understand the process of how to get on that first page and get in those top three search results, and you can get a ton of traffic and again, grow your list and monetize your business. The second thing too with blogging is that you have to understand what it takes to actually get people to your blog. Because like I mentioned in the last point, SEO is important. You need to understand Google and how to actually get content to rank. But at the same time, you also need to have other ways to drive traffic, because SEO is not overnight. I know, it's frustrating, right? There's a lot going on, but the payoff is there if you're patient and you have a plan and you execute. So that's a really cool thing with blogging, though, is that SEO is kind of a long-term play. Short-term play is understanding Pinterest and Facebook ads. So those are two ways, both a free and a paid way, to actually drive people to your website. You can try Twitter and random sites like that, but to be honest with you, not many bloggers are generating that much traffic from it. All traffic, for the most part, really comes from Pinterest, SEO, and Facebook ads. So while SEO takes a little while, you can speed that process up by running Facebook ads, installing a pixel, getting people to it, learning how Pinterest works. You know, that one isn't my specialty by any means, but it's one of those things that if you can figure out how to get traffic to your blog, then you can create a real business from it. All right, well, I know I threw a lot of information at you. You're trying to figure out, should I start freelance writing? Should I start blogging? Again, do not do what I did and try and do it all at once. There's so much opportunity out there. We live in this awesome time in 2019 and beyond where you can literally make money from your laptop. But at the same time, you need to make sure it aligns with your goals and you have the time for it, because blogging, for example, is gonna take a lot more time out of your day and it's gonna have longer results. So let's say you're in a 9-to-5 right now. You know, you don't need to quit your job or make instant income, but you really wanna create a long-term brand. Let's say you're passionate about fitness or eating right. You know, you wanna create a blog about that as opposed to, you know, going to a freelance job board and applying for, talking about online coaching or fitness and things like that. Think about how blogging in that sense could really help you out, because again, you could create an Instagram for it. You could start to understand how Pinterest works. You could build up your blog over time. You could sell courses. You could sell online coaching, all those things. Versus freelance writing is gonna be different. But let's take another example. Let's say you're still very passionate about fitness and nutrition, but you need money now. Say you're a college student, or you're someone that just has some new bills that popped up, or you just wanna pay off your debt ASAP. Then you want to become a freelance writer, because then you can make money quick, you can find food nutrition blogs and websites and influencers, and you can start writing, and you can start getting paid probably this month if you go after it. So that's again the biggest thing, is that you have to understand where you are in your life and what your goals are and what you're trying to achieve with your online business, because freelance writing and blogging are very different, but they both have tons of opportunity. But again, I want to make sure they match what your actual goals are. All right, guys, as you can tell, I'm super excited about this stuff. I love the opportunity out there and I wanna help you guys. So if you have any questions, again, always let me know in the comments down below. Also down below, I have a lot of great resources to help you launch your blog, start freelance writing, and really build your online business. So again, I'm not saying one is better than another, because freelance writing is great, blogging is great, but what I would recommend is to try not to do both at once, because I've tried that and it sometimes was tough. So unless you have a lot of time on your hands and are really committed to it, you can do both. But for the most part, I would stick with one and, you know, have a 3-month goal or a 6-month goal and stick with it. After that, you can reevaluate it, see if you want to keep freelance writing or keep blogging, mix it up or do something else. So again, hopefully that was helpful. The opportunity is out there, but it comes down to if you will learn new skills, you know, get yourself out there, publish articles, reach out to clients, all these other things. But if I can do it, I know you can do it as well. So if I can help you out at all, please let me know down in the comments. Let me know if you're a freelance writer or a blogger and what's holding you back if you haven't done either. And again, make sure to take a look at all the free resources. I have an ebook to help you launch your freelance writing business. I have guides for blogging and freelance writing as well. So take a look at the description down below. If you like this content, again, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe for more, turn on the notification, and let's be the year that you actually start a blog or start freelance writing and make serious money online. Thanks again for watching, and as always, have an epic.